A very warm good morning to one and all present over here, class. Welcome to the digital platform of APS. Now, this is Pawan Kumar. Today, I will discuss the concept related to scalar product or dot product. So, class, in previous lecture, I have discussed the last topic, scalar or dot product. So, see, now in today's lecture, I will write the scalar or dot product of two vectors. You know, in previous lecture, I have discussed scalar or dot product of two vectors. Scalar or dot product of two vectors. So, I have discussed for any two vectors, the scalar or dot product for any two vectors A and vector B, the scalar or dot product of two vectors is two vectors A and B, scalar dot products of two vector is denoted by, consider A dot B, we have taken A dot B vector, and defined by, and defined by the formula. The formula is defined by the expression. Defined by the expression vector A dot B is equal to mod of vector A mod of vector B into cos theta, where theta is the angle between two vectors. Theta is the angle between two vectors A and B, where theta is the angle between two vectors A and vectors B, such that theta is greater than 0 and less than pi. We can write theta is greater than 0 or equal to 0, this can be, and less than pi. Now, this is the range of angles. Now, you know, if either vector A or vector B is 0, then theta is not defined. So, I will write some important points. Related to dot product. So, see, some important points. Some important points Now see some important points. Now first point is, if vector A or vector B is zero vector, if vector A or vector B is zero vector, says that we can write vector A is zero, vector A is equal to zero vector, or vector B is equal to zero vector. Vector B is equal to zero vector. Then angle theta is not defined. Then angle theta is not defined. This is the first point. Now see. Or in other words, we can write zero vector has no direction. Zero vector has no direction. Second point is, zero vector in bracket, zero vector I am writing, has no direction. So there is no direction, so this will be the scalar quantity, and in case what you will write, in case we define that is A dot B, if you will calculate A dot B, its result you will get zero. Now this is the second point. Now I will come to the third point. What is the third point? This is the scalar quantity. And it is a scalar quantity. It is a scalar. A scalar vector. Or scalar quantity. Scalar quantities. Now the product is scalar and its product is scalar quantity. Now come to the next point. When it is a scalar quantity, then it will belongs to a real number. Then A dot B will belongs to real. And vector A, vector A dot vector B belongs to real number. Real number. Now see, in case you have a formula formula is A dot B is equal to A mod of B cos theta. Suppose two vectors are perpendicular. Two vectors are perpendicular. In case, what you will say? We can say theta is 90, or we can write when the angle between two vector is 90 डिग्री, दैट इज थीटा इज इक्वल टू 90. दिस इंप्लाइज व्हाट वी कैन राइट, दैट इज थीटा इज इक्वल टू 90. दैट इज देन ए डॉट बी, वेक्टर ए डॉट वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू मॉड ऑफ ए मॉड ऑफ बी मॉड ऑफ ए इंटू मॉड ऑफ बी वेक्टर इंटू कॉस 90. सो दिस इंप्लाइज वेक्टर ए डॉट वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ यू विल सी. नाउ इन फोर्थ केस व्हेन थीटा इज इक्वल टू 0, when fourth is when the angle between two vectors is 0 degree, that is theta is equal to 0 degree, then what we can write, vector a dot vector b is equal to mod of vector a mod of vector b into cos 0 degree, or 0 degree means cos 0 value 1. So this implies we can write mod of vector a mod of vector b is equal to vector a dot vector b is equal to mod of vector a into mod of vector b. Now see, if any doubts can clear it. Now I will come to the next point. The next point is point number 4. When the point number 5 is when the angle between two vectors two vector is 180 degree, that is theta is equal to 180. Then what we can write? We can write mod of vector a mod of vector b is vector a dot vector b is equal to mod of vector a into mod of vector b into cos of 180 degree. This implies we can write vector a dot vector b is equal to mod of vector a mod of vector b with negative sign, so this will be negative here, so negative times this is mod of vector a into mod of vector b. Now you can see in case of theta is equal to 180. Now I will come to the next point. The next point is Suppose you have a points. You can take example. Fifth and sixth point is. Now sixth point is. Vector and its negative vector makes an angle of 180 degree. So vector A multiply by negative of vector A. So what we can write? Vector A multiply by negative of vector A. Vector A multiply by negative of vector A. So what we can write? Mod of vector A into mod of minus vector A. So this one, what we can write? This one we can write mod of vector A negative times mod of vector A, means negative we can take outside. So minus times we can write minus times mod of vector A whole square. This is A dot A minus times mod of vector A whole square. Pi is equal to negative sign. Now seven point is, seventh point is for mutually perpendicular unit vectors. Unit vector, you know, I, j, k. So you will see this is I vector in the direction of x axis, j vector in the direction of y axis, and k vector, this is xyz axis, and this is vector k, unit vector in the direction of z axis. So for mutually perpendicular unit vectors, we have for mutually perpendicular unit vectors. Unit vectors i j k, what we can write? I dot I, unit vector I dot product with I, result will be 0. Unit vector j with j, result will be 0. Unit vector k, not 0, I dot j will be 0, I dot I, result will be 1. So angle will be 0 degree, so this result will be 1. And now for perpendicular vectors, you know, in case of perpendicular means I dot j, what we can write? I dot j result we can write also, I dot j result we can write 0, j dot k result will be 0, and k dot I result will be 0, k dot I, j dot k and k dot I, result will be 0. See, now I will come to the next point. The next point is, The next point is angle between two vectors, 8th point or 7th point. Angle between two vectors A and vector B can be calculated by using the formula. Can be calculated by using the formula, and formula is, you know, cos theta is equal to vector A dot vector B whole upon vector A dot vector B, their modulus. So this is the formula. With the help of this formula, we can calculate these angles. Now we can write theta is equal to cos inverse vector A dot vector B whole upon mod of vector A into mod of vector B. This is the formula. You can calculate easily angles. And next, in dot product, scalar product is commutative. 8th point is scalar product is commutative. So scalar product is commutative means what we can write? This implies vector A dot vector B is equal to vector B dot vector A. Both have the same result. Vector B dot vector A. So both will be same. B dot A dot B. Angle between two vector will be same. If you will take this third vector C suppose, so A dot B or B dot C or C dot A just will be the scalar. So expression, what we can write? Expression we can write the expression vector A dot B. This is the expression. And suppose when you will multiply A dot B, you will get a scalar, and you are going to multiply any other vector C. So when you will multiply with any other vector C or A dot B, suppose A dot B dot C or C dot A dot B. C dot A dot B has no meaning, have no meaning. Have no meaning. Now see, now this one is totally completed.